Hello guys, welcome to my YouTube channel. Today our topic is lazy bridges. We had already completed the Wheaton bridge. Now we are moving with the Kelvin's bridge. Wheaton bridge is used for the measurement of medium resistance, whereas Kelvin's bridge and Kelvin's double bridge are used for the measurement of low resistances. Here it is the circuit diagram for the Kelvin's bridge. Okay, it consists four arms AB, BC, CD, and DE. Okay, it is the galvanometer. It is the DC voltage. It is the Kelvin's bridge circuit diagram. Okay, here it is the It is the connecting lead. Connecting lead is connected at the two points M and N. Okay, connecting lead has a resistance, internal resistance smaller. Remember this, connecting lead has an internal resistance smaller. Okay, let us see. When galvanometer is connected at point, when galvanometer is connected at this point M, then we have S plus R. That means whenever the galvanometer is connected at this point, we have to take the opposite resistor. Okay, we have to take the opposite resistance, that is S plus R. It is the internal resistance of the connecting lead. Okay, so we have to consider S plus R from the DC bridge balance equation. Remember always, the balanced equation for the DC bridges is R equal to P by Q into S. It is the balanced equation for the DC bridges. So in place of S, we have to substitute S plus R. Okay. Similarly, when galvanometer is connected at point N, here also we have to consider the opposite resistance. That means this R. R plus R, it is the internal resistance. Small r is the internal resistance of the connecting lead. Okay, in place of R, we have to substitute R plus small r. That equal to P by Q into S. See here, it is a low result value. It is a high result value. So we have to consider the medium result. The medium result is obtained at this point. It is the medium. So we have to consider this point, that is a point D. Okay, when galvanometer is connected at a point D, we have the balanced equation R1 by R2 equal to P by Q. Okay, remember always the DC bridge balance equation is R equal to P by Q into S. Okay, we have already known about the DC bridge balance equation R equal to P by Q into S. In place of R, we have to substitute R plus R1. In place of S, we have to substitute S plus small r2. Okay. In order to find out the value of, R1, we have to find out this R1 value and we have to find out this R2 value. In order to find out the R1 value, initially we have to consider this equation, which is obtained from when the galvanometer is connected at a point D. Okay, R1 by R2 is equal to P by Q. If you add both sides 1, then we can get R2 by R1 plus R2 equal to Q by P plus Q. Similarly, R1 by R1 plus R2 equal to P by P plus Q. Okay, these two equations are very important. Then R1 by R1, then R1 by R1 plus R1 plus R2 is equal to P by P plus Q. Okay, we had already obtained this relation, R1 by R1 plus R2 equal to P by P plus Q. Then value of R1 is equal to P by P plus Q into R1 plus R2. Then R1 is equal to P by P plus Q into R, small r. Why we are substituting small r here? See here, when galvanometer is connected at this point, we are having the internal resistance R1. When galvanometer is connected at this point, the internal resistance is small r2. Okay, if you connect at this point, the connecting lead, if you connect at this D point, the galvanometer has the internal resistance is, sorry, the connecting lead has the internal resistance smaller. So, we have to consider R1 plus R2 is equal to smaller. R1 plus R2 is equal to smaller. Similarly, we have to find out the value of R2. R2, we have already obtained the relation R2 is equal to R2 by R1 plus R2 is equal to Q by P plus Q. From this, we have to find out the R2 value. Similarly, R1 plus R2 equal to small r. If you substitute both this R1 value and R2 value in this equation star, we can get, see here, if you substitute both these equation and do the manipulation, finally, we can get the bridge balanced equation for the Calvin's bridge is R equal to P by Q into S. Okay, if you have to multiply and do the manipulation, so after cancellation, we can get R equal to P by Q into S. Okay, this is the Calvin's bridge. Now, we are moving with the Calvin's double bridge. It is the circuit diagram for the Calvin's double bridge. Here we are having the two bridges, so one bridge is inside the another bridge. So here it is also having the four arms A, B and C, D. Here having the internal resistance, here are the external resistance P, Q, R, S and internal resistances P, Q and R. Okay, here we are giving the DC voltage. Okay, let us see the derivation for the Calvin's double bridge. Mainly, the Calvin's double bridge, it works on the principle of under balanced conditions, there is no current through the galvanometer, which means voltage drop between EAB is equal to EAMD. It is a very, very important relation in case of the Calvin's double bridge, EAB equal to EAMD. Let us see the derivation. So, initially, we have to find out the value of EAB. Initially, you have to find out the value of EAB. EAB means the voltage drop across the resistor P. EAB, see here from circuit diagram. EAB, okay. We have to find out this voltage drop across this resistor. Okay, EAB is equal to P by P plus Q, it is the total resistance into EAC, it is the total voltage. See here from circuit diagram, EAB equal to P by P plus Q. P plus Q, it is the total resistance into EAC. EAC is the total voltage. Okay, we have to find out the voltage drop across this resistor. That means P by P plus Q into EAC. So, we have to find out this total voltage EAC value. For that purpose, we have to consider this circuit diagram. We have to modify this circuit diagram. We have to consider this internal bridge like this. Okay. Then, it is a nodes, node A. And it is another node M, it is another node N, and it is another node. Yes, we are as it is, we are representing the internal bridge here. Okay, in order to find out the value of ESC. Here it is the resistance R, here it is the resistance P, it is the small Q, and it is the small R. And here it is the another resistor, here it is the standard resistance, yes. Okay, in order to find out the ESC value, and we have already known about the formula V equal to potential V equal to I into R. V and E are both are same only. Why? Because both are potentials only. V or E. So EAC is equal to I into R. We have to find out the value of R. R equal to R plus S. Both these, this resistance, see here, both both this resistance and this resistance are in series. Okay, so we have to add R plus S. So P and Q, these two are in series. Okay, P plus Q. So P plus Q is in parallel with this small r. So we have to get the expression P plus Q into R by P plus Q plus R. Okay. Then we have to substitute this equation and this equation. Put 2 in 1. We have to substitute this second equation in first equation. That means we have to substitute the value of EAC in equation 1. If you substitute this, we can get EAB equal to P by P plus Q into I into R plus S plus P plus Q into R by B plus Q plus small r. We can get this equation. Okay. We had already known one condition, EAM is equal to EAMD. No, we had already known this condition. We had already find out the value of EAM. Then we have to find out EAMD value. Okay. EAMD is nothing but EAM plus EMD. EAM plus EMD. We have to find out the value of EAM. See from circuit diagram. EAM. So EAM equal to current flowing through this resistor is I. So we have to consider EAM. Potential across this resistor is I into R. Potential across this resistor R is I into R. Then we have to find out the value of EMD. EMD equal to I into R value P by P plus Q. P plus Q is the total resistance into P plus Q into R by P plus Q plus R. It is the equivalent resistance. It is also obtained from the circuit diagram. Okay. EAMD. If you cancel P plus Q and P plus Q, then value of EAMD as I into R plus PR by P plus Q plus R. Okay. We had here we are having the two potentials EAB and EAMD. From the we have already known one relation. It is the principle of Kelvin's double bridge. EAM equal to EAMD. Then equation 3 is equal to equation 4. EAB equal to EAMD. It is the equation 3 and it is the equation number 4. Okay. Here value of I and I both are gets cancelled. Other gets cancelled and P by P plus Q R plus S plus P plus Q into R by P plus Q plus R is equal to R plus PR by P plus Q plus R. Then R plus S plus P plus Q into R by P plus Q plus R. We have to take this term to this side. Then it will be reversed. P plus Q by P. Then R plus S plus P plus Q into R by P plus Q plus R is equal to R by P plus Q by P plus PR by P plus Q plus R into P plus Q by P. Okay. I have to multiply R into P plus Q by P and PR by P plus Q plus R into P plus Q by P. Okay. We have to multiply these both. And if you do the manipulations, we have to take this term to this side and we have to take these two terms S plus P plus Q plus R by P plus Q plus R to this side we are minus sign will come. Okay. If you take the R as common, then we can get 1 minus P plus Q by P is equal to PR by P plus Q plus R into P plus Q by P minus S minus. Similar, same expression we get. It is a simple mathematics. R into, if you do the manipulation, minus Q by P, PR by P plus Q plus R, P plus Q by P minus 1, minus S, minus QR by P plus R. Okay. After that, if you take this term to this side, then it will be reversed, minus P by Q. If you minus P by Q, it is minus P. By it is Q. P and Q gets cancelled And if you do the finally, we can get the value of unknown resistance is R equal to SP by Q plus QR by P plus Q plus R into PQ by P minus Q. It is the unknown resistance value which is obtained from the Kelvin's double bridge. If P by Q equal to small p by Q, we can get R equal to S by S. This total term will become zero. If P by Q equal to P by Q, then R equal to SP by Q. Okay. Remember one thing, we have to consider EAB value and EAMD value. If you know the value of EAB and EMD, then we have easily find out the value of the unknown resistance.